Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to the Best Day Ever podcast. If you did not know, today is the best day ever because yesterday is gone and we're not guaranteed tomorrow. So that literally makes today the best day ever because it's the only day that you have. Today's the only day that exists. I just want to start off by saying I'm just so happy you're here. I'm just in such a good mood today. I am not going to lie, I feel like the last few episodes, like I love having pre-noted episodes where I really get into and organize what I want to talk about. But today, I just wanted to give you guys a life update. And right now, I just feel really excited just to share with you what has been going on in my life. Because if you follow me on Instagram at livefromjoy, you can kind of see I've been all over the place, and it's very much true. I've been all over. I've been living in Albania the last 6 months of my life, and it has been so amazing. It's been so special. Today, I actually had my last time teaching English courses at my church that I've been attending. I've been teaching English for the last almost 3 months, and it's been so sweet and so special getting to know these girls and boys, but specifically getting to know the girls. I've been able to grow such a good relationship with them, and I have so many fun things happening this summer. But mostly I'm just like so grateful that even though I'm from across the world, from a state in United States, and even though I'm from Pennsylvania, I was able to come here from Albania and just get to build relationships with people here, and that's so fun to me. There's been a lot of things that I've learned during my time here, and there's been a lot of things that were difficult and challenging, and I would just say in general, this year was really interesting because it was my year that I told myself I was going to allow myself to have to just explore more, explore life, explore opportunities. I knew that I wasn't willing to just stay at home in the United States. I genuinely just felt called. Like I just knew in my heart that I was meant to be living in Europe. And the thought of staying at home, it didn't even feel like home. Like home feels like here now in Albania, which is so crazy to say that. And I just feel like we really don't know what's in store for us in life. And it just goes to show how God does just know us better than we know ourselves. I never, ever would have thought that I would have ended up here in Albania. Like, that's so crazy. But of course, only God knows that. If you're watching live from YouTube, I'm still wearing my little teaching outfit. This blazer I'm wearing came from my boyfriend's mother. She gave it to me. It's so cute. I'm wearing just like a bunch of flower patterns because I'm just trying to bring some color and joy into the world by the things that I wear. I think that just what you wear says a lot to someone else, even if you're not speaking to someone, but you can actually just encourage someone just by what you're wearing. Like the dress, well, skirt that I was wearing today, it's very long and it's super flowy. And specifically here in Albania, this would be considered a traditional outfit, which is interesting because in America, everybody wears whatever they want and all the decades can be seen through different people. Just one day you go out into public, you can just see people inspired by all these different decades. But I feel like here in Albania, a lot of people just only wear very simple, modern clothing, like very glammed up, or maybe even just wearing like all black. That's very popular here. But you don't really see people wearing a lot of color. And that's viewed as like a very old thing, a old tradition. But I love that I was able to wear this because it stops a lot of people. And I think it sparks some joy in them because they have memories of wearing clothing like this when they were younger. But I'm like, let's bring it back. Like, why not wear like these beautiful dresses out and about like women did back in the day and just like show our femininity? Is that a word? Just show like our beautiful feminine side by just wearing a beautiful skirt, a long skirt. And it doesn't need to be like showing yourself in any certain way. Just like wearing a beautiful skirt one day is so fun. It's like dressing up. Like who doesn't like to dress up? I don't have a lot of time because if you're watching from YouTube, you can see that there is a literal storm headed my way. Like, actually, I don't even know if I have 5 more minutes. It's getting a little scary looking back there. But I just wanted to say hello to you and to just do a person-to-person conversation because a lot of my episodes recently, as I said before, have just been things that were on my heart, but they were a little bit more guided and structured, and it's fun to switch it up. So, several fun updates. So, the reason why today was my last time teaching English courses here is because I leave for America. I'm going back home to America for the summer, and it is so crazy and so fun, but it's so strange because my mindset of America is just like not home. And I don't know how to explain it. Literally do not know how to explain the fact that I have not felt homesick at all. Like, I've never had one day, not even a moment where I felt homesick. Like, the only way of being homesick was just that I've missed my family when I first got here and just realizing that everybody's growing up, but that's just the fact that everyone's growing up because everybody was, none of my siblings were at home. So it's not necessarily that if I stayed home, I would have time with them because everybody has been across the world. So it's just more reflecting that everybody's growing up and that our childhood just went by so fast. But yeah, so that was that. But I'm here now. Going home to America. It's going to be the best summer ever. I'm starting a ministry with a lot of people who are close to me, friends and sisters, called the Joy Club, which is just going to be a gathering of women coming together. We're going to have some structured moments where we do some more Bible studies and getting into the Word together and just empowering each other in our identity and being a true child of God. But then other days are just going to be us hanging out and going to Marsh Creek or going for a hike somewhere or maybe even going for a morning run or getting pliables together and just sitting at a park together. But I just want it to be a time in the week. It can be different days. Still have to figure that part out. But just a time of just one day of the week, a few hours of your week, where you are guaranteed to know that you're just going to be welcomed into a community where you get to be together with other girls and other young women and teens. You just know for sure that it's like a moment where you can just rest and be joyful. I hope you can just be filled up and just be excited about who you are as a child of God, who God has made you to be, and just be excited for the plans and purposes that God has for you, even though you don't know what they are, but just a time to be reminded that God is good and He has a plan for you, and that there's so much more in store of this beautiful journey we called life. And I don't know, I just want to like share that if you're someone right now that's just not feeling encouraged, just take a moment, just breathe. And I just want to remind you that you're not going to remember the thoughts that you're having today. I was just realizing that earlier. Like, sometimes I just get in a funk and I just get in a mood, but I'm like, this is not what I'm going to remember about these days. What I'm going to remember about these days is that I was young and I was 22 and that I was trying out all these different ministries and I was jumping into different communities and that I had no clue what they were speaking because I don't speak Albanian. I don't speak ship. That's like the language that they speak here. Because sometimes I just kind of get bummed out and I'm like, dang, like I really wish I could do deep ministry and I could really have deep relationships. And I wish I could have like a church that I could like really, really, really invest in more. But I'm like, why do I have these thoughts when I teach English here and I have such a close family relationship with this church here? Like, they are literally my family. I've never ever had this sort of experience with the church before. At home, my church is very, very big, and I was not at all like super attached to the members. But here, it truly is a church family, and I'm so grateful for that. And so, I'm like, there's so many things that I could counter my negative thoughts about with just gratitude. Like, when I choose to be grateful for the things that I'm complaining about, I'm just like, whoa, like, these days have been amazing. They've been the biggest blessing. And I'm not even going to remember the things that I was sad and complaining about in my mind and letting them like take over the way that I feel. 'Cause I'm like, those things literally don't matter. And I'm like, what I'm going to remember
is what matters. So I'm like, just take away those negative thoughts and focus on the good things. So yeah, I just want to encourage you that if you're feeling a certain way, like, just know that those emotions, those feelings do not last forever. And life is always changing. There's always something being implemented. There's always something that you're learning. I just love to remind people that flowers only grow and bloom when it rains. Like, it's about to right here. But, like, life is so beautiful. Like, I just want to tell you, like, life is so beautiful. Your life is so beautiful. Like, everything you've been through, everything you've done has led you right here to this moment. And it would be so cool if, like, after this podcast, you just kind of reflected on your own life. Like, you know, like, new seasons, new thing in store. It's summer. Like, I love summer so much. I think that's why I'm so happy, because I cannot wait for summer to be with my family. I'm going to be living in my own apartment, which is also really cool. So I'm going back home and I'm going to be having my own little life. And I want to take advantage of being home in Pennsylvania. I don't want it to just flush away and wait to come back here for Albania in the fall. I want to enjoy life in America. And I want to really just dive into this season doing ministry. My best friends are getting married and I'm going to be the maid of honor for 2 weddings. It's just going to be a beautiful, beautiful time. And of course, I'm going to be with my family. There's so many things I want to learn about. Like, I want to get into gardening. I want to learn how to create my own sustainable fashion. Just so many things in store. And stay tuned and stick around, because I believe this June, I would say June or July, there may be some special clothing items, a little clothing line drop happening for the Best Day Ever podcast. And if you know me and if you've seen this podcast content, you can have a little idea about what it's going to be looking like. It's going to be fun, colorful, groovy, sunset colors. It'll be even blue and green colors together for the guys. And for people who love the earthy tones. But I am so excited. So please stay tuned for that. And I'll see you guys next week. I think that's all I wanted to share. It's just a cute little quick upset. A cute and quick little update/episode. But I thank you guys so much. I thank you guys for your support. It would mean the world to me if you could just, if you would be willing to comment and review on this podcast, give it some stars. It really helps me to stay encouraged and to also continue to know what you guys enjoy, what you guys have taken away from this episode. And if you can hear in the background, that's actually the Muslim mosque having their daily prayer. I don't know if you can hear that. But yeah, I would love for you guys to just give you a review of this Best Day Ever podcast. And I also would love for you guys to share with a friend, encourage someone today. And I just thank you guys for who you are. Thank you for your support. It's been a year and a half now, almost, that I have been pursuing the Best Day Ever podcast. And this is just the beginning. And I'm so excited for everything. So I love you guys. Have a beautiful day. You're loved. You're chosen. You're going to always be loved by me, your friend, Olivia. So, yeah. See you guys next week. Bye.